Hi everyone, Phil here from Easyblog.org. In today's episode, I'm going to share 5 ways that you can level up the quality of the comments your students are both making and receiving on their blogs. Now first, I want to start by making one thing very, very clear. Any positive comment is a good comment. When I hear teachers say, "My students always just make rubbish comments like good job or awesome." When I hear someone saying something like that, I know one thing for sure, they've never blogged themselves. Because I tell you, when you've spent time and effort posting something, any comment is a good comment and they can be as rare as gold. But that doesn't mean we can't have better comments. Comments that provide useful feedback or stimulate deeper conversation and learning. And in today's episode, we're going to look at how to generate those. Number one, have a framework for commenting. 2 stars and a wish works well, or 2 stars and a question. Remember, they are a general guide, not an absolute rule. Number two, write high quality comments as part of a shared class exercise. Sit down on the carpet, display a post that you've selected, and co-author a quality comment.
This morning's post of the day is Henry talking about the biathlon.
This is the biathlon. We had to swim for 50 meters and run 400 meters. It was really hard.
Let's think about 2 stars and a wish for Henry.
Number 3. Start one day of the week with a comments of the week time to show exemplars. They can even be chosen by the students themselves from their own blogs. Number 4, create a specific template for a specific task. For example, if the class are doing a writing assignment, have them post a draft to their blog and then have them visit each other's and give comments in a structure you've already provided. They can even use the assessment rubric as a guide to help them with their comment. Number 5, and maybe most important of all, make sure that you are leaving quality comments on your students' blogs. Set aside time each week to do that and make it a priority. There are lots of other great blog posts by teachers about how to teach the art of quality commenting, and a quick Google search will turn up dozens for you. That's all for this week. See you next week for another episode of Easy Classroom Blogging with Mr. C. If you found that little gem helpful, subscribe to our YouTube channel for lots more great tips on getting the most out of your classroom blogs. Find us on Twitter and Facebook, and don't forget to visit easyblog.org now for your free classroom blog.